Is a really expensive toaster worth it?
Let's find out.
Here's the deal. I'm not a crazy toast eater, but I have been eating a lot more toast as I've been making a lot more breakfast and my family's expanded by two younglings. My old toaster, which is just a basic Cuisinart model, was, I would say, $35. Toasters have changed quite a bit. Used to be about a $20, $30 toaster and you died with it because that's how long it lived. Now, toasters go all the way up to $500. I'm not gonna buy a $500 toaster.
I am not gonna buy a $500 toaster.
The number one thing that I want out of a toaster and the highest criteria that I'm looking for, even toasting. I don't care if I can start my toast through Wi-Fi on my phone when I'm 6 miles away.
I'm gonna do this shootout so you don't have to. Time to meet the contenders.
In this corner, we have the Cuisinart CPT520. And in this corner, the Breville BTA820XL comes with a whole bunch of different settings up here, which I'm gonna go through at the end. Comes in stainless steel, the fingerprint magnet version, and that is it. The Breville, it has all the same basic features of the Cuisinart. Much simpler interface on this. Both of these have a metal casing. This one is that brushed stainless steel look that doesn't attract so many fingerprints. This one is not. It's that smoother stainless steel that shows up fingerprints all the time. Briefly, I'm gonna go over the differences between these two toasters' interface. This one has the toast setting set on the front here. Your toast buttons, you've got toast, which just starts the toast cycle. Pressing that button again cancels it, brings it back up. A bit more adds, I believe, 30 seconds. Just because a quick toast of 30 seconds. You've got a bagel mode. It has frozen, which defrosts them first and then toasts them. It has this lift and look feature, a feature that this one has that most toasters don't, which I haven't figured out why. The crumb tray comes out from the front. The interface on this one. Both of these go to sleep after about 30 seconds if you don't do anything. This one does not have a slide dial. The toast shade is just numbers. You have the options of 1 through 7. This one has 6 different bread types that it allows you to cook with. You switch that by pressing the bread type button and then click down for toast. You click up to cancel the cycle. The add 30 seconds still functions the same as the a bit more. The quick view is the same as the lift and look. This one has a single slice feature, which supposedly makes it cook a single slice of bread more evenly than a regular toaster. And it has a defrost feature, which is similar to the frozen feature on the Breville. The way I'm gonna do this testing, I'm gonna save you some hassle, but it's gonna cost me a lot of bread. See what I did there? As I'm going through this, what I'm gonna be doing is I'm gonna be trying different type of bread types, different type of settings, different type of toast settings, and I'm gonna be giving you guys some of the snapshots of what I'm seeing as I'm going through this overall evaluation and answer the question from my perspective, is it worth the extra money? Our first test, basic toast. Both of these set at the halfway mark between their toast shade settings. And we're gonna start from there. Let's toast. Test one. Even toast. But I'm gonna go further down the rabbit hole and see how the other features and different bread types work in these toasters. This one does not have a setting for English muffins. English muffin. The manual says that what it does when it adjusts for the bread type on the Cuisinart is it adjusts its temperature and time based on the characteristics of the bread. In order to test that theory, I am going to run this one twice. One with an English muffin in it to see how it actually toasts. And then again, without the English muffin setting, just to see the time difference on the same exact setting. So English muffins, pretty even toasts out of the Breville. Okay, this part here is soft and this part's toasted. Interesting, because that's not even top and bottom. So,
the verdict on that, the Cuisinart is not great for English muffins. Now we have our first differential between performance of the Breville versus the Cuisinart.
I just did a timing test with the Cuisinart to see if the manual's true on its setting on English muffin. On the same exact toast level for the regular toast, it toasted for 2 minutes and 7 seconds. And for the English muffin, it toasted for 2 minutes and 10 seconds. So basically, there's no real added time for the English muffin setting. I don't know if you guys saw that. I just noticed the way this one lowers and clips and the way this one lowers and clips on the thick pieces of bread, this one actually caught the bagel. It clipped it before it went all the way down. That'll do. One of the features that I thought was interesting about the Cuisinart was the fact that it had a single slice setting. So I did want to test that and see if it actually made a difference. It does make a difference. So this is the regular setting. That's the outside. And that's the end of it. This is with the single slice setting. Breville does not have a single slice setting. So with one piece in there, this is the outside, and that's the inside. Big pros of the Breville. It's a Breville. In my experience, longevity-wise, the devices I've had and the appliances I've had for Breville have lasted longer than Cuisinart, Kitchen, and some of the other brands. So time will tell, but in theory, a Breville toaster is going to last longer and function better, is going to last longer than the Cuisinart toaster. But I haven't bought a high-end Cuisinart toaster. All the ones that I've got have been at $25, $30 range. So the big pro of the Breville is brand name, if that still sticks, because as we know, a lot of these brands have been bought by other companies and they've changed in their quality. Everything's kind of gone downhill. Another big pro of the Breville over the Cuisinart is the simplicity of use. Yes, I'm geeking out on these things because I'm doing this testing video, but do you really want all these buttons and functions and selecting bread type and all that kind of stuff on the top of your toaster? It seems like gimmicks. The differences I saw in time and cook between the English muffin setting and the white bread setting was negligible. But you still have to click through the menu to get it to the thing that you wanted to do. The only real significant difference I see in cooking for me would be, are you cooking a frozen item or are you cooking a bagel? Because in my experience, those are the things that I toast that are the biggest difference. I like the fact that it has this easy to use and quickly adjust toast setting. I don't like clicking through the buttons to set 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, or 7. It always defaults back to the previous bread type. If I made a bagel and my wife comes down and wants to toast a piece of bread and doesn't look at the interface and check everything, she's gonna end up burning her bread. My strongest negative on the Cuisinart is the complexity of the interface. All the testing I did, toast level aside, evenness, they're both really, really close. I'm gonna go with the Breville. The main reason I'm gonna go with the Breville is because happy wife, happy life. She does not like this interface at all. She likes this one for two main reasons. The interface is easy. You toast it like a regular toaster and then you press the button. If you're doing a bagel or something odd, you select that and then press the toast button and then it defaults back to regular toast every time. And the fingerprints. Something weird that I just remembered that I forgot to cover. If you look online, there's a complaint out there about these devices making a very subtle electronic buzzing noise constantly. The first one I had, I did notice it. When this is plugged in and all the lights are off and it's in standby mode, it's making this real quiet buzzing noise. Drives me freaking nuts because when it's quiet in here, you do hear it. I can hear this thing buzzing. And it was just obnoxious to have a constant buzzing somewhere, like a little gnat in your ear. Got something to do with the capacitor on the LEDs for this. Because when you turn this all the way up, the buzzing increases. And when you turn it all the way down, the buzzing's almost non-existent. The second one I got, the buzzing is much, much quieter. It's still there. If I crank this all the way up and I put my ear right here, I can hear the buzzing. But I can live with that because I have to get that close to the toaster to hear it on this one. The first one, even when this setting was in the middle, I could hear it standing over by my stove. you do buy one of these and you notice that the buzzing is louder than you would like, or you can hear it constantly, return it. If this video was helpful for you guys, go ahead and hit that like and subscribe. I'm gonna keep doing more review videos on products that I get, just because, hey, this information was helpful for me when I look up reviews for videos on products that I'm considering. So I hope this was helpful for you.